October proved to be a month of contrast. A delicate balancing act between warm, sunny days with moments of chilling rain and morning frost. This fluctuating weather became a visual representation of the race we found ourselves in, a race against the encroaching cold. The weather presented a clear challenge, especially for painting the exterior of Well Driven, a task with minimum temperature requirement. We also had a list of other projects to tackle before the cold season would truly set in, and before Pierre's demanding work schedule left little room for boat building endeavors. Hi, we're Jen and Pierre, a Canadian couple originally from Quebec, and we are currently building our custom 37 feet expedition sailboat. We found a forgotten rusty hull a few years ago and named her Well Driven. She'll be all-electric, Arctic-ready, and one-of-a-kind. Launching in 2026, welcome to sailing Well Driven. If you're new here, we're excited to have you join our journey. If you're a familiar face, infinite thanks for your support and welcome back. Well Driven is more than a project, it's a community. We encourage you to get involved, ask questions, and share your thoughts. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already and give us a thumbs up.
Well, day one of laser. I don't know how long it's going to take.
Laser cleaning.
I don't know. Maybe two, three days.
Just going to go clean Pierre's face mask. He said there's not enough ventilation. So there's a lot of smoke coming back at him, but that's dirty. Needs a good clean. This is 5 hours of work. That's how much Pierre managed to do, but there's a problem. And the problem is?
There's a safety lens, there's a security or protective lens in front of the gun. It's located right here in this little sleeve here. The problem while we're using the gun when it's cleaning, there's a lot of dust, there's a lot of dirt that's flying all over the place, rusted, it's burnt. And a little piece of dirt, when it touched the lens, it fries the lens. So in order to finish the job, I would need more lens.
Which we don't right now.
We only had a few when we bought the machine. So now we're out of it. And there are, it's going to take a little while before we get them, probably somewhere next week or the week after. So for now, all I can do is finish painting what I've burned, and hopefully we get the lands early next week or the week after, and I can finish the work before it gets too cold, because right now
it's freezing.
There's a race against winter.
Yeah.
And I think I'm gonna lose. So,
well,
that's the thing. It is.
It's out in Ontario. We could have some surprise.
Yeah. Next week they're calling for 20 degrees. So it's 5 degrees today, and next week it's gonna be 20. So, but hopefully by that time we get the lands and we can finish. There's at least another, I'd say 5, 10, 20, at least another 15 to 20 hours of prepping. And after that, it's painting. But I'm not going to take any chance. I'm going to paint already what's been burnt, because I don't want the rust to stick to what we've done already.
And you're happy with the thinning?
Yeah, I think it's does the job. I don't think it's... I think it's as good as sandblast without the damage, without the mess, because the sandblasting makes a big mess. There's sand all over the place, there's sand in the boat. We were planning to sandblast the boat, but I'm glad we changed our mind. Hopefully we'll be able to get the paint all done before the fall, at least a two protective coat of 300. And after that, we'll wait for the spring to put the real color. We're not even sure what color it's going to be, so
that's going to be a surprise.
Yeah.
Pierre is very dirty on his back and on his toque. It's because he's been laying on the ground there.
Sleeping on the job.
Well, sleeping on the job, yeah. No, so it's just so he could do the bottom part of the boat.
Remember when Pierre said it would probably take a week, two at the most, to receive the replacement lenses? Turns out, when we confirmed the order, the delivery day was set for November. Nothing was available before. Looking at the forecast, we knew we had to adapt in order to complete the task. So we had to bite the bullet and we went with the original option. And we did brace ourselves for the huge mess. Hey guys, sorry for the interruption. I'm taking a quick break from editing. It won't take long and it's for a very good cause. Pierre's colleague and friend is looking for a live liver donor for their infant son. They made an interview with CTV News just a few days ago. I will put the link in the description below for the full interview. Please watch it, share it, and hopefully they will find a perfect match for their son. In the meantime, I'm just going to share key moments of the interview, and we will be back at the show right after.
We should note William's condition means he's been on the transplant list essentially his entire life.
That's right, Tony. William was diagnosed with urea cycle disorder, a rare genetic disorder, a few days after he was born.
His liver is missing an enzyme, and he can't break down and process protein. So because of that, ammonia builds up in his blood, and that's very toxic, especially to the brain.
So you go on the transplant list with a score out of 40, so he's a 40 out of 40. Yeah, so he can't go any higher. Somebody with an O blood type, it can be positive or negative. Anyone from the ages from 18 to 55, obviously the younger the better, but as long as the liver's healthy, as long as the person's healthy, and ideally they're looking for somebody 70 kg or less.
William is receiving food and medicine every 3 hours to help him stay ready for a transplant.
The two brothers that were blasting the boat had to stop at one point. They couldn't see anything. They said they were used to work in a closed environment, It wasn't their first time in a shelter like this one, but we still felt bad for them. Some of you may remember the show Dirty Jobs with Mike Rowe. That's definitely one of them.
Me blast metal. T'es content? Ah, ils se sont promenés pas à peu près des insectes. C'est comme une autoroute d'insectes. Everything is covered in sand. Every single thing.
Yeah, the paint is so thick. Doesn't have the same texture.
No, very light. Check the time. I want to see how long it takes before it starts turning solid.
All right. Seems to cover very well, huh?
Yeah. Sticky like crazy. I'm sure if I drop the roller, it's going to stay there. I want to take the opportunity to thank Teller Marine that's been giving us a big hand on deciding and how to paint and all this stuff, the technical aspect of painting the boat. Really nice. Pete, thank you very much. And no, he's not a sponsor, but he's a good friend now.
Awesome guy.
Awesome.
Then it was time to dress up, to crawl underneath the boat to paint the bottom. And just like that, all the steel was painted and we were done. When we bought the boat, it came with a used windlass and about 100 feet of 8 mil chain. We decided to change the windlass for a slightly bigger one and bought 200 feet of 10 mm chain. Pierre had to make the new cutout for the new windlass and he used the template provided with it. A few months ago, we decided to design a crash box that would double as the anchor chain locker and a storage place. Pierre cut the opening and will then proceed with tacking the frame on which the hatch will be installed. Next on Sailing Wild Raven.
My main concern, I want to make sure it's nice and stiff, solid, and it doesn't leak. I think they call it stacking diamond.
We finish installing the frames for the deck and roof hatches. We make one more hole on the cabin. We receive a special delivery. And we'll be sharing an exciting news with you. For you.